In this video, I'm going to show you how some basic animations can be carried out in MATLAB using simple functions. First, we'll be creating the figure in MATLAB using some simple basic functions and then move on to animating it using some for loops. Let's begin by creating the objects in the image. The first object is the sky. For creating the sky, we'll be using the fill function. The fill function gives a polygon of the given coordinates of x and y. We can also specify the color of the polygon. Over here, I have used a blue color polygon. So I have specified the RGB color for blue. So let's run this part of the code and see our output. As you can see, we have got our polygon of the specified x and y coordinates and the color. The next object is the sun. For the sun, we'll be using the polar coordinates of the circle. The sun basically has three parts: the body, the vertical rays, and the angle rays. For the body, we'll be using the polar coordinates of this circle, and we'll be using the fill function to fill it with yellow color. Then we move on to the vertical ray, that is at angle 0, 90, 180 and 270. To plot the rays, we'll be needing two x coordinates and two y coordinates, which will give us the line at the given angles. The same procedure is followed for the angled rays. When you run this code, we can see the sum. The next object is the rainbow. For the rainbow, we'll be using semicircles of different colors and appending it one above the other. For this, again, we'll be using the polar coordinates of the circle from 0 to pi. So what we do is, first we fill with the red color. Let's see how our output looks when all the colors are created and appended one above the other. As you can see, the rainbow of different colors has been created using semicircles of different colors. Next object is the cloud. For creating the cloud, we have 7 elements, that is, we'll be using 6 semicircles and 1 rectangle to create the cloud. For creating the semicircles, we'll be setting different values of t, that is, first value is from 0 to pi, second value is from pi by 2 to 3 pi by 2, third value is from pi to 2 pi, and the fourth value is from 3 pi by 2 to pi by 2. And we are going to place it in such a way that it forms the outer boundary of the cloud, and then in the center we are going to place a rectangle that covers the remaining part. Let's run this part of the code and see how our cloud appears. I'll be creating two clouds, one on each side of the rainbow. As you can see, we have two clouds placed in our image. Next, we move on to creating the boat. For the boat, again, I'll be using the fill polygon function. Over here, I'll be specifying the x coordinates and y coordinates, and I'll be setting the color as black. So this will be the base of the boat. Then I'll be creating two decks for this boat. So let's run this part of the code. As you can see, I have my boat ready. And the final layer is going to be the sea or the waves. For this, I'll be using a sine function. The color will be set to blue. Finally, you can see that the image has been created. Now, let us try to animate this image. Over here, I'll be moving the boat from left to right and the clouds as well. Then I'll be creating an effect such that it appears that the waves are moving. So let's move on to the program. For this, I'll be using a for loop and two extra variables j and z. The variable z is used to create an effect on the waves, and the variable j is used for moving the cloud and the boat from left to right. As you can see, for the cloud, the variable j has been added to the x-axis value, and the variable z is used to get different amplitudes of the sine wave. Let's run this code and see how the animation works. How we can carry out simple animation using MATLAB.
Thank you for watching this video. Do like this video if you found it helpful. Follow us on LinkedIn, Facebook, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Education is our future. MATLAB is our feature. Happy MATLABing!